Jennifer Lopez, by any standard, is remarkable. She dances, she acts, she sings, she produces, she marries Ben Affleck several times. And after 30 years and her fair share of ups and downs, she's still looking good at the top of her game. Her new film, The Mother, has gone straight to Netflix, which sadly is the fate for many genre thrillers these days.
Where's my baby?
You wasted FBI time trying to cut a deal for yourself, and 7 agents were killed. This conversation now takes place on our terms.
We meet the mother, no name, being held in a safe house by the FBI. She's about to spill the beans on 2 high-level bad guys, Adrian and Hector. And it's pretty clear the feds aren't fit for purpose. J-Lo does the job for them. Did you expect otherwise? Even though she's 9 months pregnant. Wait, what?
Adrian Lavelle and Hector Alvarez are still out there. You and I both know the only way you protect that child is to disappear.
And if I don't?
They'll find you. Both of you.
The boss of the fatally incompetent FBI squad, a brief cameo from Edie Falco, advises the recovering J-Lo that she's now a real mother, but she can't keep the baby. With Hector and Adrian on their trail, she has no choice but to go solo. The selfless mother agrees to go off the grid, but tells FBI agent Cruz to keep an eye on the baby.
You're just going to vanish?
You put her with good people. Keep her safe. If there's trouble, let me know.
Now, off the grid means Alaska. 12 years pass, not that you'd know it. The Alaskan climate must be good for the mother's complexion. And we wait for Agent Cruz to sound the alarm, otherwise there's no movie. Without her child in danger, her name's Zoe, by the way, J-Lo can't turn into an action movie mother.
Out.
Zoe is taken. Jennifer hotfoots it to her rescue, and you soon notice one thing about the film, a rare action thriller from Kiwi director Niki Caro. It's mostly about one person and one person only. There may be an endless supply of bad guys and a few FBI agents to get in the way, but the mother is all about the mother, meaning Jennifer Lopez.
What do they want?
Revenge. They're using her to get to me. ¿Dónde está la niña?
So don't expect early friendships with Agent Cruz or Alaskan neighbour Johns to come to much. The mother not only has no friends, she doesn't seem to need them. She does require a daughter, and once she rescues Zoe, a certain amount of chemistry is cobbled together.
Run!
What's your plan?
She needs protection right now.
Who are you?
From here on, you do everything I say.
You're driving.
I'm 12.
Let's go.
The hook at the start is that Zoe has no idea that this bad-tempered superwoman is in fact her birth mother. In fact, she's only interested in getting back home to her non-heroic adopted mum. This is clearly the part of the film that Niki Caro responded to most, and to the director's credit, it adds a little warmth to what could easily become a brutal video game.
I hate it here. I want to go home.
Not till you know how to survive. Everything it takes.
You're scaring me.
Every time I look at you, I'm scared.
Look at the mess you made.
But the mark of a film that's failing to grab my attention is when I became sidetracked by non-essential matters. Like, who came up with the names Hector and Adrian? They sound less like brutal gangsters and more like a couple of Cuba Street hairdressers.
You're not getting away this time.
You burn down our entire world for her.
Yes.
Hector's played by former Mexican superstar Gael Garcia Bernal, who seems to be going through a quiet patch in his career. And the same seems to be the case with Adrian in a rather bigger role.
We die, and she survives. If that's what you want, take a breath and tell her.
Under all that scar makeup, it's Shakespeare himself, Joseph Fiennes, gritting his teeth and wrestling with Jennifer Lopez in the Arctic snow. Director Niki Caro does a pretty good job in the action scenes, by the way, but the best thing she does is at the end when she wraps up the action with a Kate Bush classic called This Woman's Work.
Be God, you can call.
Did J-Lo push for one of her own numbers? Let's Get Loud, say, or This Is Me? We may never know, but Kate was definitely the right choice, effortlessly adding class, as always. OK, The Mother may never be a timeless classic, but it could have been so much worse. It's currently showing on Netflix.